A second really important subspace of Rn is known as the null space. Recall, we're interested in the solution of Ax equals b. We've seen that if we have a specific solution, and we have a solution that maps to zero, then adding those two factors together gives you a solution. What we would like to do is have a way of identifying the set of all vectors that map to zero, because it's that set of vectors that can be added to a specific solution to come up with all possible solutions for Ax equals b. The set of all vectors that are mapped to zero by matrix A is called the null space of A. And the notation is the script n, which denotes the set of all vectors x such that A times x is equal to zero. The name null space kind of gives it away, doesn't it? So you can imagine that the null space of A is indeed a subspace. And how do you prove that? Well, the zero vector is certainly in the null space, because A times zero is zero. If you have two vectors that are in the null space, then adding them together is also in the null space. Why? Because if you do A times x plus y, you get A times x plus A times y. But if each of these vectors is in the null space, then you know that that's just zero plus zero, which is zero, which means then that that's in the null space. If you have a scalar alpha and a vector x that is in null space, then if you do alpha times x, you better end up in the null space as well. Well, notice that if A times x is equal to zero, then A times alpha x is equal to A times alpha x, but you can bring the scalar out, and this then is just a zero vector, and therefore you get alpha times a zero vector, but that's just a zero vector, and therefore alpha times x is also in the null space of A. We're going to see lots of examples that illustrate the importance of the null space, so just hang on.